What's going on? I'm back with another video, and yes, it is snowing here where I am, so that means no school. I'll take this chance to go over another uniform with you. All right, so today we're gonna take a look at the BDU, the Battle Dress Uniform, also known as the Camouflage Utility Uniform. So as of right now, January 2011, the NSCC regulation does have the BDUs, as well as the NWUs, the blue digital uniform that the Navy uses. All right, so let's go straight at it. We'll start off with the 8-point cover. So this is the basic 8-point cover camouflage utility uniform. Make sure you do get the 8-point. There are ball caps out there that are, you find at the surpluses. With this cover, you have the small camouflage utility flash that just faces to the right. Some people have rank on there. Everyone, officers, cadets, leaguers, all have this flash on there. Maintenance stuff that you can do to it, but just keeping a paper plate in there. So take a regular paper plate, cut out the middle, and trim the edges so it fits nicely to the corners. You don't have to make it a perfect 8-point, but enough to keep that shape present. And the other thing is the corners like to tend to curl up like that, so pinch it down to get a little temporary fix on it. I'm hunched down, but this is how you wear it. The regular two-finger rule applies. You just want to have it tight fitting around the back, not too tight where you feel a throbbing, but enough so it doesn't really fall off when you look down. You know you got the right sizes. If you can wear it properly without the top of your head busting through the top of your cover, that way it just looks like a flat 8-point cover. And just looks a lot nicer that way instead of looking like a ball cap. And a couple of last things on the cover. I like to keep the bill bent. And lastly, the sign inside says, do not use starch. That's also a good place to put your name on it. But don't be afraid to use starch on it. Just don't put too much when you iron it. Just because you want to keep it looking good. So we'll take a look at the boots right now. You can wear this with black socks or olive drab green. Alright, so the boots that I have are from the Navy Exchange. These are the Belleville's all leather boots. The regulation manual does not specify what kind of boot you need to have. It just has to be a high top 9-inch boot, so you can have any kind of combat boot, jungle boot, zipper boot, so anything works. It just has to be black. So it's pretty simple, just kind of keep them clean. These haven't worn these in a while, so they're pretty dirty and pretty dinged up. So just rub some polish on it, and you don't have to buff it too much. Just keep the toe a little shinier than the rest, just to make it look presentable. Aside from that, you also want to keep the midsole clean, just like the dress shoe, the surface dress blues. These collect a lot of dirt and a lot of dust, so just take a toothbrush and rub some polish on it. Lastly, a handy way to not lose your blousing bands is just to kind of put a bend in it within the laces. That way, you always remember to put it on and that you always have it. All right, next we'll just go over the pants real quick. The only thing that has special about it is above the right back pocket, you have your last name. And everything else is pretty simple. It's kind of, before you wear it, just iron everything down. Some quick tips, don't iron on the buttons because the buttons will show through and that just looks a little bit heinous. And it's pretty simple to maintain. It's got straps on the side to fit your waist tighter. And the belt to go on this is the black open face buckle with black tip. So, all right. So right now, let's take a look at how exactly I put on these boots with the black tip. Something cool about these boots in particular is that these boots have this little seam in the leather, and that's at the second eyelet for the boot laces, and that's really where you want to have your blousing end, and it's really nice how they incorporate that in the boot. That way you get it spot on. And lastly, a quick tip with the boots, I could learn this from my brother, who's a Marine, is put a little overhand knot at the end. That way, it doesn't come out from the eyelets and makes getting them on a lot easier. All right, so before I move on to the blouse, we have the plain brown shirt. It is simply a plain brown shirt. When you wear this shirt, you want to have it tucked in at all times, and that's pretty much the only thing that goes in regulation with this. All right, so I'm gonna hold the camera for this just to show you the blouse as best as I can.
All right, so we have the USNSCC above the left breast and your last name above the right breast pockets. Before I move on to the other parts of the uniform, that's what happens when you iron on the buttons, so don't do that. Same with the trousers, you want to keep this uniform nice and flat, wrinkle-free. And what I didn't cover with the trousers, but also applies to the blouse, are these pockets have these expanding fabric on them, so you want to iron that down and tuck those fabrics in when you iron it, just so it doesn't puff out as it usually does. Same with these corners, they have a tendency to curl outwards. Get that down as well. Next, we'll go on to the collar. You want to have a nice pressed collar, nice and flat, a good size and shape V right there. And now to the collar insignias. You only wear these if you are E4 and above. And the way that the uniform store issues their collar tabs are in these little squares. So it's pretty easy just to put them where they are. Just keep them balanced on the sides and directly down the center line. And that rule for the collar goes for only this uniform and the NWUs. Once you get onto the khakis and the dress whites for chiefs and officers, that's when you have to apply some measurements. Moving on to the shoulder flashes, same with any other uniform, the eagle and the anchor face forward, and that it is 1 inch away from the shoulder seam. The hard part about this uniform is figuring out where it's centered on this, because you have to stitch it centered, but you don't have a crease on top. So a trick to do that is find your seam on the bottom, iron it out lightly on top, just so you know where the center is on the upper of the shoulder and arm area, and just center it among that.
So those are all the components for the battle dress uniform. Some last things on that uniform is that during the summer, your unit might choose to roll up the sleeves. I'll attach the link to a video of the way I like to have the sleeves done, and also show you this picture right here. And this is a picture of when I was a senior drill instructor, and this is just the way I like to have the sleeves look. It's really tight. The uniform manual says to have the bottom of the sleeve roll 2 inches from the elbow, but I prefer to have the top of it end right at the bottom of the shoulder flash. It looks a lot better, and having it that high is what a few cadets have learned at their master at arms trainings. Alright, so that's the BDU uniform, also known as combat utility uniform. Again, I'll attach a link to the uniform manual for all of these things that I talked about. If you have any questions or comments, just put it down below. If you find this helpful, I appreciate any comments that you have on what can make these videos a lot better. So as for now, I'm Pastor Castro, and until next time.